Hello, my name is Bart de Best. Welcome to the SLA series. This is part 7. What is the content of the DFA? And abbreviation stands for Document Financial Agreements. So this is a picture that we will see at the end of this movie as an example how to calculate the total cost of ownership of a service. So the agenda for this movie is first talk about what is the DFA about, then the goals, the subjects in the DFA, and the example. So when we talk about the DFA, we talk about the financial aspects of the services that are agreed upon in the SLA. And the reason to have that in a separate document is that it might be confidential information that you do not want to share with everybody. So, the goal is to agree upon the financial aspects of the total service provisioning. And the basis is the SLA. Normally, the financial aspects of the DFA are not changed during the year. It is done, if it is changed, at the end of the year, when also the SLA is reviewed and re-signed. So what are the subjects that you might find in the DFA? Well, first of all, the policies. So the policies are about the financial agreement. So why do we want to have this kind of a DFA? Is it about that you want to outsource the services and that you want to know the cost price? Or do you want to have a service center instead of a cost center? You might have an uplift of the total cost of ownership to make investments in innovation of products and services. And of course, it depends on whether it is an internal DFA or an external DFA. Internal DFAs are very open and the total cost of ownership is shown. And there is only a DFA internally used if it adds value. So if the customers can't change their behavior of their consumption of the goods and the services, then does it matter to have a DFA? For external, of course, you have to always a DFA. Because you want to be able to invoice the customer for the consumption of the goods and services. When we have a DFA, then the total cost of ownership is calculated based on the content of the SLA. And then charging is possible. Charging internally can be done by having a budget. And then based on the budget, there is an amount of money transferred to another budget. Externally, it's of course the money to be paid. And then the bonus malus, that might be used externally. For internal use, it doesn't matter because that doesn't count up. An external supplier might have a bonus malus agreement with the consumer. And then when there is an SLA and the SLA norms are superseded, then you will get a bonus. That means you get extra money. And when the SLA norms are not achieved, then you will get a malus. That means you have to pay money as a provider. It's always limited to an amount of money. The real damage of a customer based on the bad service provisioning, you don't see that often to be compensated by the supplier. Most of the time there's a maximum. And the maximum might be the money that is paid to do the service offering. And then we have the invoicing. And the invoicing, that is about, of course, the amount of money that's charged. And that is only done externally. So let's look at an example of the price structure. So in the price structure, we see three steps. First of all, we see the determination of the cost factors, the cost elements. And then we see that they are subdivided in three categories. And then for a service, the price is calculated. Now, this is a picture that explains it. So there are cost elements, typically 5 to 10. And you have a weighting factor. And the weighting factor that describes which percentage of the indirect costs and which percentage of direct costs are calculated to compensate the other costs that are left. And in that way, the total cost of ownership for our service B is calculated. Okay, what's next? We have a number of movies. So we are now at module 7, and the next module is the operation level agreement, module 8, part 8. And of course, as you know from the prior parts, you know that you can subscribe to this YouTube channel. Of course, become on LinkedIn, follow the training of ITMG, or buy my book, SLA, Best Practices. Okay, that was it for the DFA for this movie. I hope to see you in the next movie. Bye-bye.